Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new here. Today's video is going to be part two of my two-part holiday gift guide. So part one, which already went up, was focused on beauty. If you haven't seen that yet, that will be listed below, but today's video is going to be focused on lifestyle gifts. So I have gifts for candle lovers, coffee lovers, wine lovers, I have clothes, some cozies. We have a lot to get through, so we're gonna jump into all of that in a second, but before we do, please don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, click on that notification bell, and drop a comment below letting me know a gift idea that you have for this holiday season that you are really excited about. Thank you so much for doing all of those things. It really helps to support me with the YouTube algorithm, so I appreciate you so much. And if you need anything from me at all, it is always listed in my description box below, including Lightroom preset filters for editing your Instagram photos, my SPF merch, discount codes, timestamps, links to all the products that I'll be talking about, and links to my favorite beauty products as well. All right, let's jump into it. All right, let's start off with gifts for candle lovers first. So this first candle, I know I've recommended this so many times already, but I have to bring it back because I love them so much. So these are the wellness candles from the Project 62 brand at Target. I think that they are so pretty, very clean, very simple aesthetic, which is definitely my kind of vibe. They all have this white glass jar with a bamboo lid, and there's a bunch of different options for fragrances, and each of the different fragrances says a different word and has a different colored label, but all the colors are really muted and subdued, which is definitely my kind of vibe. So this one says gratitude. I have one sitting behind me that you can't even see when I film because I'm covering it up. That one says daydream, but this gratitude one smells so good. It is bergamot and fig scented. This daydream one right here is cactus and rose scented. Oh my gosh. And there's a lot of different options as well. These are definitely not the only two, but even though they all have different fragrances, I feel like they all give off the same type of vibe where they're really calming and homey and fresh, and they just smell so, so good. None of them are too intensely fragrant either to where they're going to give you a headache or just be too overwhelming. I just feel like they're absolutely perfect. And every time I have them lit in my apartment, and I have people over, I get compliments on the smell every single time. So if you're looking for a candle to give as a gift that's not going to break the bank, definitely check these out. And then the other brand that I would look into for candles is Way. They have a very simple aesthetic as well. I absolutely love the ceramic stoneware, the pale colors. I think it's so pretty. And this is set up similarly to where they have different colors for their different fragrances. So Way Hair Care has signature fragrances that they've now turned into perfumes and now candles. They're in their hair care products. They're in their body care products, and they are amazing. I have raved about the smell of Way Hair Care products so many times before because they definitely just are elevated compared to other brands. I feel like it's getting up there close to like an Orbe type of thing. You can't be Orbe, I'm not gonna lie, but Way comes close. So this pale pink color right here has their Melrose Place fragrance, and this one's very, very floral and fresh, but it also kind of has a little bit of a spiciness to it. It's definitely a very sophisticated scent. I like that one a lot. And then this one, which is more of like a grayish, has their North Bondi fragrance. So this is also a floral scent, but I feel like it's not as sophisticated and kind of spicy as the first one. It's a little bit fresher and almost kind of has like a beachiness to it, even though it doesn't smell tropical. I don't know, it's a little hard to explain, but I really love this one too. And then I have two different candle accessories that I feel like could make for really good add-ons to a candle as a gift. The first being this rechargeable lighter. I just think that this is really handy because then you don't have to continue to repurchase lighters. And it has this really bendy head to the lighter. I don't know what else to call that. That makes it really nice because then you don't have to worry about burning your fingers when you're trying to light your candle. But if you are gifting to somebody who maybe doesn't like to light candles because they're afraid to leave them burning when they leave the house, or maybe they live in an apartment or a dorm where they're not allowed to light candles, I would definitely recommend this candle warming plate. This thing is amazing. All you do is plug it in, put your candle on top of it, and then it just melts down the candle and you get that fragrance wafting. So it doesn't work any less, like the candle doesn't smell any less fragrant using this versus a lighter, and it's a really great option for those that can't use one. All right, let's move on to gifts for wine lovers next. So first, I have to recommend my wine and champagne glasses. I think that they are so, so beautiful. I stared at these for months and months and months, and finally for my 27th birthday, I was like, you deserve it. time for some new wine glasses, and I am so glad that I made the purchase. So these are from Crate & Barrel, and I just feel like they're so unique, but really elevated because they have this straight flat edge that you just don't typically see in wine glasses. So this is the red wine glass. I love how big it is. This is the champagne flute. Beautiful. I also have the white wine glasses. I will say that they're a lot smaller than I was anticipating, and I always find myself reaching for the red because I just love how big this is. Like, this fits my kind of pour better, but if you're really into like specifically having a white wine glass, those are pretty too. They just don't have the same like oomph that these do because of how big and tall these are. So, oh, beautiful. Lipstick and gloss stains. Typical. And then I have a few different accessories here as well that I love. So the first is this electric bottle opener. I love this thing because I cannot open a bottle of wine that has a cork in it, not a twist off, to save my life. Like, if it was life or death, I would not be making it out alive because I would crack that cork into like 2 to 3 different pieces. I do it every time. I don't understand what's wrong with me, but this helps to just make that a lot quicker and easier of a process. Next, I have this wine vacuum that you just put on top of the bottles, and then it's a little vacuum. It comes with these wine stoppers, and it's going to help to keep your wine as fresh as possible for as long as possible. So I think that that is a great little duo, again, for anyone that is a wine lover. And last is my wine aerator. It actually also comes with this little straw that you attach. You stick this in the bottle, and then you pour your wine from here. For those of you that are really into wine, you're gonna roll your eyes at me because I don't understand how this thing works or what it really even is doing, honestly. I originally got it because I read that it would filter out the tannins or whatever's in the wine that gives you a headache. That's apparently not actually true. That's kind of a gimmick. But what this is supposed to do, allegedly, is enhance the flavor of the wine. So as you're pouring it, it'll create these air bubbles. I just like the sound of it and the experience. I think that it works, but maybe that's just like a placebo effect thing. I still think it's a fun gift. All right, now for coffee lovers. I have a bunch of different mug and cup options here, which may feel really excessive to some. Those of you that are obsessed with coffee, you know there are different kinds of mugs and cups for different coffee purposes. So I'm gonna share them all. The first mug, which is absolutely my favorite, is this Yeti. I am in love with this thing. I could not live without it because it keeps my coffee as hot as possible for as long as possible. So if you're somebody that feels like you don't drink your coffee fast enough and it gets cold and you have to reheat it, this will solve that problem for you. So I can sit and be drinking this casually while I'm reading or going through emails, and it never gets cold. It is seriously the best. I also, for obvious reasons, I'm obsessed with this white, but they do have a lot of different colors available as well. And they also have different size options. So they have, what do you even call it? Like tumblers and mugs without handles. So if this size is not for you, then get a different size, but still Yeti. Hot coffee. Next is a ceramic mug that I got off of Amazon. This is so beautiful. This is one of the prettiest things that I own, I think. I love the look of this. Obviously, the pale pink I think is gorgeous, but if you're not into the pink, I totally get it. They do have different color options available, but it's a ceramic mug that has this really nice soft touch kind of sleeve on the body of it. And this is a better option for on the go. So if you're going on a walk, if you're in the car, because that specific Yeti doesn't fit in mug holders in your car. Maybe if you want to have it sitting in your lap, it is just such a nice, sleek little ceramic mug that I love so much. But my personal favorite option for walking is this collapsible mug. So this is another Amazon find. Again, you don't have to get pink. They have other color options, but this is so great if you like to go on a walk in the morning or at any time of day with coffee or just a beverage, but you don't want to hold on to it afterwards. So this fully collapses. Come on, don't embarrass me. There we go, like this, so that you can fit this in your pocket. Is this not the most genius thing ever? And then you don't have to hold on to it when you're done. Love that so much. Last is specifically for iced coffee lovers. So this, I think technically is supposed to be a beer glass, but I love it for iced coffee. I want a clear glass for iced coffee because when I pour my creamer in, I like to watch the swirl. Like the whole thing is an experience. If you're an iced coffee drinker, you know exactly what I'm talking about. There's just that special moment when you're pouring creamer in. So I love this for iced coffee. I'll actually link the black straws that I use with this that fit perfectly in my description box as well. This is my favorite for the summertime when I'm having iced coffee. All right, we are moving right along here to apparel, outerwear, things of that nature. And I actually have four different coats that I wanna share. Again, that probably feels really excessive, but they're at different price points. So the first two are definitely pricier and quite a splurge, but the other two, which are actually the same coat, just in two different colors, are really, really affordable. So I wanted to just show them all because I love them all and give you guys different options at different price points, depending on your budget. So this first one, oh my gosh, this is from Aritzia and it is called the Cloud Puff from their Wilfred brand. Oh my effing God. This thing, it truly does feel like a cloud. The squish, the comfort, this is like a dense pillow. It is so amazing and it has this really pretty beige color and it is like a corduroy fabric with a ribbed look to it. I think that it is so, so cute and you will catch me in this all fall and all winter long because I feel like it is just the perfect super cute jacket to accessorize any outfit if you don't feel like really doing much else. Like you can throw this on with a pair of jeans, some cute boots, and you're good to go. The second splurge is also from Aritzia, and this one's actually a vest, but if you like this and you want it in a coat, they do have this exact same color, finish, everything in a coat, plus tons of other options as well. So they have different colors in this shiny look. If you don't like the shine, they have black with matte. They have different matte colors as well. They have just an insane amount of options in this style, which is their Super Puff original. So another one that is unbelievably comfy and warm, so squishy. I love it so much. And I really love this shiny black look. I think it is so freaking cute. I don't remember the exact name of it. So of course I will have that listed below if you want this same finish. And I also love the fact that it has a hood. So again, I know it's a splurge. For me, I feel like I'm just at that point in my life where I can splurge on items like this that feel like staples for me that I'm going to have forever, and I will have these forever. Okay, for the budget option, I am so excited to have found these because is this not giving Aritzia vibes? Like, is this kind of not exactly what we were just looking at? So this is a puffer from Target, and it's from their A New Day brand. They have tons of different puffers available this year as well. So similar to Aritzia, a lot of different colors and finishes. So this one has that same shiny look. I think it's so cute, but they do have matte options available too. So this one is in black, and then I got the exact same thing, just in more of a beige creamy color. I'm obsessed with both of these. They're definitely not nearly as warm and dense and comfy as the Aritzia jackets. I mean, obviously, I think these were like $35 a piece, so a fraction of the cost. Of course, the quality is not going to be the same, but looks wise, I feel like it gives you that same vibe. So I'm picturing myself wearing these like for a brunch where I'm out and about, maybe not being the most careful with my jacket, and I don't want to have something super nice on, but I still want that same kind of look. Like this is what I will be wearing four times like that, you know? Brunch gets a little out of hand for me, is what I'm trying to say. Okay, last outerwear item, I have these super cute hats from Abercrombie. I know, I've told you guys this a million times, my toxic trait is buying the same thing in multiple colors. We saw it with the jackets. I can't help it. I've been this way for as long as I can remember, but I think that both of these are just really good stable colors. So like I would wear this with the cream jacket and I would wear this with the black one, or the cream one works too, but I think they're so cute. I love the brown with little black tip furry little pom-pom on top. I think these are absolutely adorable. So I will be rocking these all winter long. Next is a robe from Target. This is from their Stars Above brand, and this is so nice and cozy. I love this so much. The material is so, so soft. I actually think that they have blankets in this exact same material, if I'm not mistaken. It's just that comfortable. It feels like you're wearing a blanket, but it's not too hot and heavy to where you're gonna start like sweating and feel like you're suffocating in it. It's just the perfect thickness for the winter time. Oh my goodness, this is my fave. To go with the robe, I have the best pair of cozy, furry crisscross slippers ever. I talked about these in a favorites video and told you guys I had been on the hunt to find the perfect pair forever because everything that I had shed like crazy. These do not shed. They are unbelievably comfortable. They're durable. They're sturdy. They hold up. I love everything about these. They do have different colors in these as well, and I plan to purchase more. I need a pair for like every room in my apartment because that's how much I love these. For a non-furry, non-cozy, yet still comfortable footwear option, I have these pillow slides. At the time that I purchased these, almost all of the colors were sold out except these, so I'm not in love with the khaki color. It's definitely not my first choice. They have a lot of others that I wanted that were not in stock at the time, but they are so, so comfortable. I love these, very squishy. They are so great. These have definitely replaced my old Adidas slides for my apartment shoes. I know, it's crazy. I still love those, but these are just definitely comfier. Size up in these though, for sure. They definitely do run small, as an FYI. All right, the last category I wanted to include is cookbooks. So I love gifting cookbooks. I feel like it's such a nice gift because you're not only giving people the gift of new inspiration for recipes, but they also make for really pretty home decor in the kitchen as well. So all of these cookbooks are really pretty, but have amazing recipes. The first is Kristen Cavallari's True Comfort Cookbook. Her True Roots cookbook is amazing as well. I'll list that below too. But this is a better option, I think, for the winter time because it just has heartier, cozier recipes. That's her. That's not a recipe. There. I feel like that illustrates what I was saying. Really good stuff, and they're nice and healthy recipes as well. Define Dish is a great option for anyone that is on a healthier eating journey because this has tons of amazing recipes in it that are all Whole30 endorsed. Yum. And a lot of these are really easy to make too, which is one of the reasons why I love it. I feel like there's just tons of good ideas in here, and she has it broken up by type of cuisine. So she has an Italian section, a Mexican section, a Thai section, I believe. Yum. So good. But the one that I think is the most beautiful and has the heartiest, most delicious recipes is Half Baked Harvest. So this one is not necessarily as healthy as something like Kristen Cavallari's cookbook. Like, we have a hearty mac and cheese recipe in here, but oh my gosh, these recipes are delicious. There is such yummy stuff. I stay on the pasta pages. All right, you guys, that's everything that I wanted to include in my second and final gift guide of 2021. I really hope that you found this helpful. You'll have to let me know in the comments below if you decide to purchase any of these items as gifts for others or maybe as gifts for yourselves. If so, let me know what you decide to pick up. And as always, they will all be listed and linked in order of mention in my description box below. If you enjoyed this and found it helpful, please don't forget to give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, click on that notification bell, and send my channel to a friend. Thank you so much for doing all of those things. It really helps to support me, so it means so much. Stay tuned for my next video. That will be up in a few days, but until then, I hope you have a great few days.